Imagine discovering an oasis in the vastness of the tropical Atlantic. A place with shallow, sheltered, crystal clear waters. Where you could swim peacefully. The nearest continent is more than 300 kilometers away. This must be how the spinner dolphins feel when they reach the island of Fernando de Noronha, off northeastern Brazil. The dolphins visit the island almost every day. Here, they are already part of the landscape. The most charismatic inhabitant of the most beautiful Brazilian island. Spinner dolphins are truly ocean wanderers. They live in tropical open seas around the world. Some may spend years without seeing land. But these are different. They belong to a population known as the Noronha Spinners. Their home is a large area of deep open ocean off northeastern Brazil, around the islands of Noronha, Rocas Atoll, and a few sea mounts. But almost every day, part of this population visits Noronha. And one place more than anywhere else. Dolphins Bay. This beautiful sheltered area on the northwest coast of the island is a magnet for spinners. Considering the number, frequency of visitation, and amount of time the spinners spend here, this could be considered the most visited bay by dolphins anywhere in the world. But why do these oceanic specialists come in such big numbers and so frequently to Noronha? What do they do here, and why does the island seem to be so important for them? The answers to these questions are very important to the future of the Noronha Spinners, since they were not the only ones to discover this paradise.
Em 1990, quando eu cheguei em Fernando de Noronha, o turismo estava começando. Naquela época, Noronha recebia algo em torno de 5 mil turistas a cada ano. Hoje, em 2015, a gente tem mais de 70 mil visitantes por ano aqui no arquipélago e em Noronha tem mais de 50 barcos que saem para observar golfinhos quase que diariamente.
In 1988, a large area of Noronha became a national park. All because of its stunning scenic beauty and amazing array of marine life. Noronha has 14 sandy beaches. One of them, Sancho Bay, is considered the most beautiful in the world. It's warm, crystal clear waters are perfect for diving. More than 170 species of fish can be found in the reefs around the archipelago. And of course, Noronha has a breathtaking sunset. Who wouldn't want to visit such a paradise? Today, Noronha is easily accessible via several daily flights from northeastern Brazil, and tourism is still increasing. The beaches and waters of Noronha are a dream destination for ecotourists and divers. But the arrival of so many people brought big challenges to conservation of marine life in Noronha, especially for the dolphins. In the last years, dolphins have been mutilated and even killed in accidents from fishing lines and boat propellers. And there are further impacts that few of us realize. Maybe only those who venture underwater do.
O impacto sonoro sonoro, que é o que a gente não vê dos pontos de observação, ele é muito importante nesse turismo de observação, porque ele é um dos principais impactos que causa o maior prejuízo para os golfinhos. As embarcações, elas fazem muito mais barulho dentro d'água do que fora d'água. Isso a longo prazo, várias embarcações durante muitas horas próximo dos grupos de golfinho, isso pode causar até uma perda auditiva nos grupos de golfinho.
This means they could lose one of their main ways to sense their surroundings and locate food. They use an internal sonar that is able to sense the distortions of high-pitched sounds they emit and produce an image of what is around. Two researchers realized that the Noronha spinners needed special attention.
A nossa preocupação é que se esse crescimento fosse desordenado, pudesse trazer problemas para os golfinhos, como mudança de comportamento ou até fazer com que eles não viessem mais para Fernando de Noronha.
Nós sentimos a necessidade de criar uma ONG exclusivamente voltada para a pesquisa e a conservação dos golfinhos de Noronha. Então, em 1990, nós iniciamos as atividades do projeto Golfinho Rotador com a obtenção da primeira licença concedida pelo então IBAMA, gestor do parque. Nós não tínhamos carro, nós não tínhamos nenhum meio de transporte e íamos a pé para a Baía dos Golfinhos. Passávamos lá o dia inteiro observando os golfinhos sentados na pedra do mirante dos golfinhos.
The Spinner Dolphin Project was born. The first observations made by the researchers show that the spinners usually arrive in Noronha right after sunrise, spend the day in sheltered waters, and return to open ocean in the afternoon. But researchers needed to know much more if they wanted to understand how man could affect the lives of the Noronha spinners. What were the dolphins doing in these sheltered waters, and why did they seem to need Noronha so much? There was only one way to find out.
Os primeiros mergulhos, a grande dificuldade era entender o que estava acontecendo. Não é tanto golfinho em grupos grandes passando em alta velocidade, aglomerações, grupos se juntando e se separando, de modo que a gente demorou alguns mergulhos até conseguir entender aquele movimento e separar os comportamentos.
To observe the dolphins' natural behavior, the researchers had to improve their diving skills and change their behavior while approaching the pods.
O mergulho com os golfinhos, para que cause o menos impacto possível, ele tem que ser o que a gente chama de mergulho passivo. Movimentar lentamente, sem grandes agitações de água.
And by gently entering the dolphins' world, the researchers finally witnessed some amazing behavior. Some dolphins seem to get into slow motion. As if they were in trance. Some even close their eyes. This is the closest these dolphins ever get to sleeping. The slow movement of the tails is just enough to allow the spinners to reach the surface to breathe. Noronha sometimes becomes a large resting sanctuary for the dolphins. But coming to Noronha is much more than finding a place to relax. Mothers here are always busy. Milk's expressed right into the calf's mouth. And calves are fully weaned at about 1.5 years old.
E quando a gente consegue ver de perto uma amamentação, é uma grande satisfação, porque a gente nesse momento tem a certeza que está conseguindo interferir o menos possível no comportamento dos golfinhos e a gente se sente até parte do mundo dos golfinhos.
Here, several females with calves swim calmly in small groups. Noronha seems to be a nursing area for the spinners. But in the same area, other dolphins are becoming more active. It's mating time. The courtship starts with a soft touch. When a receptive female is around, the race is on. A large group of males can chase a single female for long distances. The competition is intense. Here in Noronha, the males always place themselves below the female. One female may mate with several males in sequence. For this reason, males never know exactly who their own calf is. In this world of paternal uncertainty, it pays off to be kind and helpful to anyone. And that's why, in this group, all spinners help take care of the young. And in Noronha, something else can get the dolphin's attention. A piece of sargassum weed. Nobody knows exactly the rules of this game, and if there are actually any. But the dolphins love to catch the floating pieces of seaweed, pass it from one part of their body to another, and even leave it to be caught by another dolphin. And what seems like simple playtime may actually help the dolphins to socialize and even practice their swimming skills. Some important abilities for a social and agile hunter. And when the spinners visit Noronha, they interact with other inhabitants of the archipelago. Some fishes are actually very grateful to the dolphins. When spinners are around, they get free food. Dolphins' waste is very rich in protein. What a gift! After all, there's no accounting for taste. There are more than 12 species of fish that take advantage of dolphins' waste here. And some can even anticipate the dolphins' behavior. When the spinners swallow water, it means they are about to regurgitate to get rid of spiky and undigested squid beaks. Fish immediately follow the dolphins. And seconds later, gorge themselves in a cloud of food that is nutritious and easy to swallow. But here, the spinners also show what they are famous for. They are some of the most agile dolphins. And of course, the most incredible marine acrobats. Some say these acrobatics are sort of an exhibition. Who spins more times? Who goes higher? Spinners can go as high as 3 meters and spin up to 7 times around their bodies. Another use for these moves may be to get rid of unwanted hitchhikers. The remoras, a fish that attaches to the dolphins using a modified fin that works like a suction cup. They can be quite annoying for the dolphins, as they increase the drag and make swimming more demanding. Maybe the acrobatics could dislodge the remoras. Especially when dolphins hit them hard when diving back into the water. After all, what is the main function of these amazing acrobatics for the dolphins?
Tem várias hipóteses para a utilização do salto pelos golfinhos, e certamente também tem várias utilizações. Uma das que a gente acredita mais é que é um meio de comunicação entre eles. Para cada tipo de salto que os golfinhos fazem, quando ele entra na água, produz uma mancha no formato característico. Os golfinhos, através do seu sonar, conseguem ver esse tipo de mancha e entender a mensagem que está sendo passada por aquele salto.
All these observations about the dolphins' behavior clearly show that Noronha is an important area for resting, nursing, mating, and socializing. Feeding has never been observed in the sheltered waters, suggesting that the spinners come to Noronha for breaks after feeding excursions in open waters. To minimize the disturbance of tourism on the dolphins' behavior, the local authorities, with the aid of the Spinner Dolphin Project, created a management plan for the areas around Noronha. Boats are not allowed to drive too fast near the dolphins, and neither can they repeatedly cross paths between them. And recreational dives with the dolphins are strictly forbidden. The researchers collect data to check whether these rules are keeping the dolphins undisturbed. The number of dolphins visiting Noronha has been carefully monitored for years. The work begins even before the sunrise, when part of the team heads to Dolphins Bay.
Faz o monitoramento 6 dias na semana, sempre de segunda a sábado, e a gente tenta chegar aqui às 5h30 da manhã. Aí a gente tem uma equipe de pesquisadores que vão se revezando em turnos até pelo menos 4 horas da tarde.
Environmental data are collected every time the researchers arrive.
A gente coleta alguns parâmetros ambientais, principalmente a velocidade e a direção do vento, e a agitação do mar e a claridade da água.
Information that is important to understand the conditions in which the dolphins maximize their use of the bay. The hard work starts when the dolphins arrive in Noronha, as all of them must be counted. Dolphin passes, researcher clicks. The best time to do it is when dolphins are entering the bay and still swimming in a more organized formation.
Nosso recorde foi de 2.719 golfinhos em 19 de janeiro de 2014.
The researchers also provide free gear and information to the tourists about the dolphins.
Bom dia, meu nome é Rita, sou bióloga, pesquisadora do projeto.
At the end of the day, all data are analyzed at the Spinner Dolphin Project's headquarters. Here, even each individual dolphin is cataloged. This is possible thanks to the presence of marks and details unique to each individual, like this scar in this dolphin's dorsal fin, which shows that this very same individual visited Noronha in 1991 and again in 2000. All these data are published in scientific journals. And most importantly, the researchers have frequent meetings where they discuss how this knowledge can help the local authorities to preserve the marine life in Noronha.
O projeto Golfinho Rotador conduz aqui na ilha de Fernando de Noronha o mais longo programa de monitoramento, que é da espécie golfinho rotador, que é um dos principais alvos de conservação, tanto para o parque quanto da APA de Fernando de Noronha. Através desse acompanhamento de mais de 20 anos aqui na ilha, a gente tem informação suficiente para fazer a gestão da conservação da biodiversidade aqui na ilha.
But even with all these efforts, in 2006, data on the amount of time the spinners spent in the bay started to indicate that something was off.
Hoje, os golfinhos só ficam 2 horas por dia na Baía dos Golfinhos, contra 8 horas, como era no passado.
Researchers were concerned the spinners would leave Dolphins Bay, or even worse, the island of Noronha. A further analysis confirmed something that the researchers were afraid of. The time the dolphins spend in the bay reduced drastically after a great increase in the number of boats cruising nearby. Even though the boats were not allowed inside the bay, they were apparently interfering with the dolphins' behavior. Researchers suspected that the noise of the engines was resonating inside the bay, disturbing the spinners. The researchers noticed that the dolphins were apparently shifting to other areas of Noronha.
Ao mesmo tempo que foi diminuindo o tempo de permanência dos golfinhos na Baía dos Golfinhos, foi aumentando em outras áreas, especialmente na região entre ilhas, onde os golfinhos passaram a ocupar durante mais tempo e mais frequentemente.
And the team immediately added a new point to monitor the dolphins. The Forte dos Remédios. This is a high lookout with a view of the northwest coast of the island and the local harbor.
A rotina daqui é diferente da Baía dos Golfinhos, principalmente pela presença intensa dos barcos aqui na área.
At a fort, 8 in the morning is rush hour. This is when the tour boats leave the port. A National Park Ranger now joins the team.
A gente trabalha em conjunto com o ICMBio e o fiscal do ICMBio, e aí ele faz a parte de fiscalização, a gente apenas orienta as embarcações. Embarcação, por favor, diminui um pouco a velocidade, tem um grupo de golfinhos à sua frente.
Besides orienting the boats, the researchers started a new investigation.
Para a gente entender essa interação dos golfinhos com o turismo, a gente faz observação em ponto fixo, em mirantes como esse daqui, onde a gente consegue, de cima, ver todo o acontecimento, desde o comportamento dos golfinhos antes da embarcação chegar e como que eles vão reagir com a aproximação dessa embarcação. Então a gente vê a velocidade que essa embarcação está se aproximando, qual o procedimento e manobra que essa embarcação faz quando encontra com os golfinhos e qual a reação deles antes, durante e depois da aproximação dos barcos. A gente já percebe que embarcações que se aproximam de uma forma mais rápida, embarcações que têm motor de popa, como as lanchas, os golfinhos reagem de uma maneira mais intensa, normalmente se afastando dessa embarcação. Já com as embarcações de madeira, que têm um motor de centro, os golfinhos têm uma reação um pouco menos intensa, onde eles acompanham essa embarcação, que é onde os turistas conseguem ver esses golfinhos, e esse motor também não causa tanto impacto porque ele não emite tanto som dentro da água. O impacto sonoro para os golfinhos ela é bem menor com as embarcações de motor de centro. Essas diferenças nos mostram que é possível navegar próximo dos golfinhos sem causar um impacto muito grande.
These results will help improve the regulations on boat traffic around the island. But focusing on just where the dolphins are is not enough. The beautiful island of Noronha is a sanctuary for marine life, and the actions on land can also minimize our impacts not only in the dolphins but in a whole ecosystem. Sustainable practices and environmental education became big aims for Spinner Dolphin Project. An example that begins at home. The project's headquarters is solar powered and has a rainwater harvesting system. The production of waste is minimized, and recycling is encouraged. Native plants are cultivated, bringing beauty and shade to the building. These ideas were introduced to several guest houses on the island through offered training programs.
O projeto Golfinho Rotador fez parceria com os meios de hospedagem da ilha e o grande objetivo desse projeto foi mostrar para o estabelecimento como é que a gente poderia melhorar as nossas atividades, colocando em prática a parte de sustentabilidade, como a água, a energia, o lixo. Aprendemos a ter esse caminho da sustentabilidade porque os estabelecimentos estão todos dentro de uma unidade de conservação ambiental e precisa ter a consciência da preservação.
Courses on environmental sciences are also frequently held in the local school. All of them have local communities' participation and respect and incorporate traditional culture. But surely the greatest fans of the spinners are still to come. What local kid wouldn't love to see Noronha's most special inhabitant? And the best part of watching nature with kids is that they can't hide their excitement. These kids get a chance to explore the waters of Noronha and develop, from a young age, a bond with the marine inhabitants that share the island they live on. We only take care of what we know and love, and there's no doubt that they love these dolphins. Still in the high cliffs of Noronha, researchers are always observing the spinners. And actions taken towards the conservation of these amazing marine inhabitants seem to be working.
O número de dias por ano que os golfinhos vêm a Fernando de Noronha e o número de golfinhos a cada dia tem permanecido constante desde o início do nosso trabalho. Isso é, em 95% dos dias do ano tem golfinhos e uma média a cada dia de 350 animais.
These results bring hope for the spinners. But any change in the behavior of these dolphins should be monitored closely. A promise that some dedicated people will certainly keep.
A pesquisa científica diretamente sendo aplicada para a conservação é o que mais me dá satisfação. Alguma, a gente quer bloquear esse turismo. Pelo contrário, a gente quer que ele continue por muitos anos, mas de uma forma que os turistas fiquem felizes, que a economia local continue se utilizando dessa forma de passeio, mas que isso não cause nenhum prejuízo para os golfinhos.
The place and the animal are truly special. The connection between Noronha and the spinner dolphins may be thousands of years old. Nobody knows exactly when the spinners began to visit the archipelago. Certainly, all people that live and visit Noronha hope to maintain this relationship for a long time. Today, this outcome is certainly in our hands. The way we behave on land and in the sea will define whether the island of Fernando de Noronha will keep hosting one of the greatest spectacles of our oceans.